This takes us to the point of the show that we like to call the information action ratio. The information action ratio
is the place to go. When the Sun Goes Down is the 11th track on the album and was released as the band's second single on the 16th of January 2006, along with B-sides Sticking to the Floor, Settle for a Draw and Seven. More on those in the coming weeks. It's 3 minutes and 20 seconds long and has 330.1 million streams on Spotify, making it the most streamed song on this album. It's number one. It's not Dance Floor, it's number one. It's this, it's number one. We got a new name in the production this time, a chap named Mike Crossey, who is an award-winning British music producer, songwriter and mix engineer based between Los Angeles and London. He has worked with the likes of the 1975, Foals, Jake Bugg, Snow Patrol, Two Door Cinema Club, Keen, 21 Pilots, Imelda May, KID and Wolf Alice. So an eclectic mix. And he will pop up again in our next era, old Mickey Crossey. So, you know, yeah. Can't wait for that. The song is 168 beats per minute and is in the key of B minor. Other key tracks in B minor are Pill Popper's favourite Faithless with Insomnia, The Only Man on the Planet That Doesn't Want to Marry Rashida Jones, Quincy Jones with Ain't No Corrida, and Posh Boys Passing as Punk Prodigy with Keep It For Her. You made me go then. I didn't think that was that good.
Oh, God. Oh, my God. That's your best one yet. Oh, God. Oh, that's better than the Kanye West one.
I didn't think that was that good. I thought, oh, I haven't really done any good ones this week. So that's nice. But I don't even know.
I do want to marry Rashida Jones. So, yeah.
Everyone does, except Quincy. Even Quincy, maybe. Knows. Yeah,
I don't milk it.
Well, I went the other way with that. I'll jump back in with the next bit then. You can just cut when I laughed at the end of the last bit.
No, we're keeping that in because that was good.
Okay. The song has been played live 438 times, firstly at the infamous Boardwalk Sheffield on November 3rd, 2004, and lastly at Leeds Festival on August 24th, 2014. At that same gig, they played the outro to Are You Mine 3 times as they finished early. So lovely that. The song is about prostitution in the Neepsend district of Sheffield, where the band practiced and was originally known as Scummy. In the weekly charts, in Australia, it reached 26. Belgium's Ultra Tip Flanders, it reached number 12. Number 15 in Belgium's Ultra Tip Wallonia. Number 6 in the Europe Eurochart Hot 100. Number 89 in the German chart, which, you know, considering they have quite a big German fan base now, they obviously didn't at the beginning. Because now, like, they're so big that their European tour is basically just different German cities with, like, two other places mixed in there. So it'd be interesting if anyone from Germany could get in touch and let us know whether, when it was, what era that they kind of became big there. Was it AM? Was it before that? Was it after that? Who knows? Maybe. I mean, this is only two singles in. So I won't judge them too harshly.
If anyone from Germany does get in touch, don't mention the war. I mentioned it once, but I think I got away with it.
Yeah. Ireland, it reached number 11. Number 72 in the Netherlands. But again, always low in Holland. Get off the wacky-backy and start listening.
Go buy some singles.
Yeah, and not single cigarettes over there. You can buy single spliffs in there. Number one in Scotland, number one in the UK, and number one in the UK indie chart as well. The song was covered by Lack of Afro in a soul funk instrumental that you can listen to here.
Before we get to it, this might well be one of my favourite things you've ever asked me to clip up for this, because I have been bouncing around. Funk's
what about when you filmed my OnlyFans clips for me? Was that not?
Oh, well, it was the close-ups in that I wasn't a fan of.
What a nerd.
And the rest of it. But yeah, I've been pogoing around to this, but it's quite fast even for funk, and it's difficult to work out how to dance to it. I'm sure the listeners will be working it out for themselves now. ¶¶
the thoughts I get listening to that is the kind of bar like in the Northern Quarter in Manchester. That there's a very specific bar. It's called like Number 33 or something like that, and it's got a couple of floors. I can't remember the exact name of it. And if you go in there on a Friday night on the second floor, they've got like just a dude DJing. It's tiny, not like huge, but dude DJing, pretty lively. He'd be playing that. There'd be a couple of people up just like vibing on the dance floor. There'd be a few sort of art school fashionistas sat having a chat about veganism. And then there'd be like sort of me and a couple of mates sat there with a few drinks as well. And the bar would be pretty busy. And that's the kind of vibe that I get from that song. It's, yeah. I do have it's to say music, the little...
I can hear myself having to shout over to order a drink.
Yeah, exactly. That kind of vibe. Yeah. Well, you know, like a place that's really like banging with the music, but there's only a couple of people dancing, but it's just a cool vibe. That's the kind of music I can get from that. But I have to say the little like flutey, like in it really gave me Anchorman vibes. You know, when he's playing that and he's under the toilet door. Yeah. What are you going to say? Yeah. He's like, he's like, oh no, I wasn't prepared at all. And he like pulls it out of his sleeve. but yeah, that's what all I could hear when I could hear it. That took over for me. But good little remix cover, whatever you want to call it, that, isn't it? Good use of a good song. Interesting if you listen from the start as well, if anyone goes finds it. Lack of Afro, as I said, it's called. From the start, it kind of starts more with the Arctic Monkeys vibe and then it switches, and it's pretty cool. So that's the end of the information this week, because there is more, but we're going to filter that in throughout the chat as we go, more information and stuff as we discuss the song.